8 points.
Now again, most Hindus take a lot of this as matters of faith. I take these as real because of my experiences. Let me share some of those. First, we hope to have experiences of that state of oneness with God before we attain the ultimate state, stop being real. It's called samadhi. And we spend a lot of time working with this concept of consciousness because everything is consciousness. So one of my earliest memories was in second grade, I think. I was on a playground in grade school, and I remember stopping and sort of contemplating what is consciousness. I probably didn't know the word, I was just aware of it. Aware of awareness. You notice that you can't feel it, you can't touch it, you can't measure it, but it's clearly there. How does it get created? Because it's not matter. Does it end? Does it begin? And that sort of thing. Maybe everybody has thoughts like that, but I think I did because I had done so in past lives. Then when I was 14, I became a Hindu because of this experience. I took a class like yours. There weren't many secondary schools in St. Louis that had classes like this back in the 1960s. I went to Burroughs. Houston Smith had been a professor at Washington U. And my teacher, Burroughs, knew him. You're reading the same book, I think, that I read when I was in eighth grade, just because it was an earlier version. So, raised a Presbyterian, I didn't really understand any of this. I wasn't very religious anyway. I just wanted to play football and get rid of my apathy and meet girls and all that. So, like, kind of interesting, intriguing, but I didn't get it. You know, how much did you get in eighth grade anyway? So that summer, my father took us to Nantucket Island for a vacation for about 3 months. And we were in a little village at the end of the sandy road, and there was nothing to do, no store, no restaurant, literally nothing to do, no people my age to hang out with. I was 14 now, I couldn't drive, it was just crazy bored all the time, trying to think of things to do. You know, we didn't have computers, television practically, in these days. Out in this little village, there was one little black and white TV, so it was totally boring. Trying to always think of things to do. One afternoon, I was walking on the beach, and it was 2 o'clock, and I remember hearing in the class that Hindus chant Om. I didn't know what it was. I've told you what it was, but I didn't know that. All I knew is that it was a sound. And so I sat down and I thought, well, I could probably burn off about 3 minutes trying to do this chant, and then I'll be totally bored and get up and find something else to be totally bored. So I sat down and I started chanting, and that is not what happened. Almost immediately, it changed from Om to Aum, which is the long version, which nobody had told me it was, but Om is actually 3 letters, A, U, and M. And then almost immediately after that, I found myself chanting 3 notes simultaneously as a chord, which they trained for decades to do in the Himalayas, which I didn't know, I'd never heard of that. Didn't know how I was doing it, why, or what I was doing. I believe my soul knew how to do that and told my body what to do. Now there's 3 notes coming out of my vocal cavity simultaneously, and the beat starts chanting, the cosmos starts chanting, and then the cosmos is chanting alone, and then there was just Om, and then there was just pure consciousness, and 6 hours later I came out. Been a Hindu ever since. Before I anticipated the question, I was always asked, what did you tell your parents? I told them nothing. I had no concept of that, what it was. I intuitively knew, but I couldn't put words to it. I don't think I even met a Hindu for maybe 40 years after that. I think at the time there were like 6 Indians in St. Louis. Now there's 15,000. So, I just kind of buried it. I went on about being a high school student, and then I went to college, and then I became a lawyer for about 25 years. I was Barnes Hospital's general counsel. I set up PJC Healthcare. I was real materialistic, just into not getting fired and doing mega deals and making money and being powerful and all that kind of thing. Married a Catholic woman, raised 2 Catholic sons, one of whom is very Catholic, and the other of whom is into the religion of baseball, he tells me. So anyway, then in 95, my mom was told she'd be dead in 6 months, and I received a calling to create a place to tell people they would be dying, and that ultimately became the center I wrote.